In this video, I'm going to share some of my favorite little-known ChatGPT hacks. Hey everybody, Katie Lance here, and I'm so excited to share some of my favorite hacks that you may not know about when it comes to ChatGPT, especially if you're in real estate. Tip number one, use ChatGPT to create verbiage for your listings. Now, I'm sure a lot of you are already doing this, which is great, right? You're probably going to ChatGPT and you're saying something like, write a 500 to 1,000 word property description about 123 Main Street. Here's the property details. Here's what the tone should be. And that's great. But what I want to encourage you to do, and this is where the hack comes into play, is I want you to think about all the different types of marketing you do with your listings. It's not just writing a property description, right? You're probably putting it up on your website. You might be creating a blog post. You might be creating a property description. You might be doing print marketing like postcards or ads in the newspaper or in a magazine. You're doing social media posts. You're sending emails to your colleagues. You're sending emails to folks in your database. So the hack here is really thinking of all the different things that you do when it comes to listing marketing, and then using ChatGPT to help you in that process. Again, ChatGPT is not going to replace you. It's not going to replace your personality and who you are. But let me just tell you, it can be a huge time saver. I know for a lot of real estate agents, you're generally really good at the business of real estate, but often what a lot of agents struggle with is the copywriting, coming up with unique content, unique verbiage. So the hack here isn't just thinking about the listing description, it's all the other things that you do with your listing marketing and having them all in one place. I always encourage you, when you're thinking of listing marketing, start with the property description. So you're gonna go into ChatGPT, again, be specific what you need, kind of think about the sort of the who, what, where, why, and how. Think about exactly what you need, the format you like it in. Once you get that listing description, then you can go in and ask for social media posts, email marketing ideas, blog content, and the list goes on and on. Hack number two, organize your ChatGPT results in Google Docs. Okay, this is a big one, and if you've been on any of our ChatGPT webinars or training, you know I've talked about this, because look, social media is rented ground. We don't own it. ChatGPT is rented ground. We don't own it. So I'm a big believer, if you are getting a lot of marketing ideas and you're using ChatGPT, to not just let it live in ChatGPT. And I learned this the hard way. I remember the very beginning days of ChatGPT. I was playing around with it. I was like, oh, this is so cool. The next day I went back to look at my chat history, and there were so many users that the site had frozen. And so my search history had disappeared, and I was like, oh, all that stuff that I had written out and searched for and everything from the day before was gone. So I like to use Google Docs. Google Doc is, Google's free, obviously, which is great. I open up a blank Google document, and I usually will use a Google document for any kind of marketing that we're doing. So I'll give you a quick example. These types of videos I will have in one Google Doc. I might have ideas. I might have video editing notes for our editor. I might have captions. I might have social media content. I put it all into one document for that specific piece of content. For you as a real estate agent, I would do this. If I had a listing, let's say I had 123 Main Street as a listing. Every time I had a new listing, I would open up a blank Google document, name it whatever the property is, and then I would, after I go into ChatGPT and ask for all the different things that I'm asking for, listing descriptions, social media posts, email ideas, whatever it is you're asking for, you're gonna take those, copy those, and paste those into a Google document. So not only do you have them all in one place, but now if you have a virtual assistant or someone on your team who's helping with some of that marketing, you've got it all in one place. Hack number three, generate email replies. Okay, so generating email replies, I love this. We get so much email, right? I don't know about you, I open up my inbox every day and it's like, oh my gosh, how many emails do I have to delete till I get to the real emails, right? And when it comes to the business of real estate, how you come across with your email is really, really important, right? It says a lot about you, how just your tone, your professionalism. And if you've ever struggled with, you know, coming up with the right words to say, ChatGPT is fantastic, not just for email marketing and mass email marketing campaigns and email newsletters, which it's great for, but you can also use it if you are communicating one-to-one. In fact, in one of our other videos, we talked about a tool called ChatGPT Writer. ChatGPT Writer is a great free extension that you can use within ChatGPT, which I love for one-to-one emails. So if you've got a delicate email, an important email that you need to send, that where you need to come across as articulate, professional, perhaps empathetic, and you're really wondering like the right tone to take, how to phrase what you want to say properly, you can use a free tool like ChatGPT Writer to say, hey, this is the situation, this is what I'm looking for, and it can help tremendously with that one-to-one communication. It's one of my favorite hacks. By the way, this has been helpful for you so far. We'd love if you'd hit the subscribe button and the bell button as we have new videos that come out each and every week. Hack number four, use ChatGPT to write LinkedIn articles. Yes, LinkedIn. We actually did a whole video about this. I'm gonna make sure we link that below. LinkedIn, I know for a lot of agents, is kind of like the set it and forget it platform. Like, you set it up at one point, you haven't done a whole lot with it since. And I think LinkedIn doesn't get as much attention as like Instagram or TikTok or Facebook or YouTube, but LinkedIn is one of the only professional social media sites that's out there. And LinkedIn is a great place to connect with people who are not on TikTok, who are not on Instagram, right? The C-level executives. And one of the ways to get traction on LinkedIn beyond just connecting and updating your profile is to write LinkedIn articles. This is something you can do absolutely free, where you can just log into LinkedIn and there's a little button that says write an article, and you can write an article and actually turn it into a newsletter that you send to anyone you're connected to on LinkedIn. We do this a couple times a month, and using ChatGPT to write this has been a huge time saver. So what I'll do is I'll go into ChatGPT and I'll say something like, I need you to write a LinkedIn article, something I'm going to post to LinkedIn, and I'm a social media strategist. I need it to be about this topic, and this topic, right? So if you're a realtor, you could go into ChatGPT and say, hey, I'm a realtor in Manhattan Beach, California, and I need you to write a LinkedIn email newsletter about tips for moving to Manhattan Beach. What's the difference between Manhattan Beach and other beaches in Southern California? You're gonna give them a few different prompts. You're gonna put that into ChatGPT, and then it's going to create a great newsletter for you. Now, as a little side bonus tip, if you're someone who is already creating some content, let's say you are a realtor in Manhattan Beach and you have a great YouTube channel or you have a great TikTok channel where you're talking about tips for moving to Manhattan Beach and you're talking about community information, you're talking about your local area, guess what? In your ChatGPT newsletter that you are creating for LinkedIn, you can take some of those links and add those to your LinkedIn newsletter. So this is a small thing that I've done. I will often, again, think about what can I send out to my followers, my connections on LinkedIn. I'll look at some of my recent videos, and when I'm going into ChatGPT, I'll use those video ideas as prompts inside of ChatGPT, right? So I might say, hey, write a LinkedIn newsletter about this topic, and this topic, and those are three topics I already covered on my YouTube channel, which means when I've got that newsletter, I can put it in LinkedIn, and then I can link to those videos and that content. So not only are you putting out really valuable content to your LinkedIn audience and you're staying top of mind, you're also linking to additional content and you're driving traffic to your Instagram or TikTok or YouTube. It is a huge win-win, and especially if LinkedIn is part of your social media strategy, I really would definitely encourage you to check out ChatGPT, especially for writing LinkedIn newsletters. Hack number five, craft SEO-friendly YouTube descriptions. All right, I feel like this is a little meta since we're doing this on YouTube. One of the things that I think is so important with YouTube videos, one of the things I've learned over the years, is how important your descriptions are and how important having an SEO-friendly description is. Now, SEO, if you're not familiar with that term, is search engine optimized. And YouTube, as we know, is the second largest search engine in the world. It's owned by Google. So a big mistake I see agents and brokers make when it comes to their YouTube content, you may have the best video in the world, but if your title's not specific, if your description doesn't have a lot in it, you may not get a whole lot of traction on YouTube. So I love to go into ChatGPT, and I will often go into ChatGPT, especially for YouTube, and I'll say, write me a YouTube-friendly description, an SEO-friendly description about a video I just did, and I'll give some context, right? The video is about this, 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 and this. I'll also ask for keywords. I'll also ask for a compelling call to action. You can ask for it to include emojis if you like to include emojis, and it's gonna come back to you with a pretty robust description, which again, just like anything else with ChatGPT, we're gonna read it over, we're gonna double check it, we're gonna make sure it's good to go, right? So great hack, especially for YouTube. It's definitely a small thing that can really take your YouTube to the next level. Okay, I would love to hear from you. What are you using ChatGPT for? Do you have a hack, something that I didn't mention? Let me know in the comments below, like and comment below. And if you're looking for any kind of marketing or content ideas when it comes to ChatGPT, we would love for you to download our free ChatGPT checklist. You can go to katielance.com/ChatGPT, katielance.com/ChatGPT, and check it out. All right, until next time, we'll see you soon. Bye for now.